I am so glad that I get to make this video from Vietnam, Hanoi. And trust me, you will fall in love with the coffee scene here, even if you're not a coffee buff. I will tempt you with all of this in some other vlog, but for now, let's go through some really important details for the Vietnam e-visa and also the updated form, because you can end up in trouble if you're making mistakes with the form. Watch till the end to see how you get the visa, because you will not receive it on your email. Before we start, some important points. Tickets are not needed before filling the visa form. Insurance is not required but highly recommended. Make sure to fill the passport expiry dates very carefully, as people get in trouble because of this. Estimated time of issuance is 3 days, but I suggest applying at least a week in advance. You do need some details about which port you will be entering, so prepare your mind in advance. Same for the port of exit, but it's still a little flexible. And you do not need proper reservations or flight tickets, but still you need an address that you need to fill out in the form. If you search for Vietnam visa on Google, you will end up with shammy links and whatnot, so avoid doing that, and instead just type out Vietnam embassy in whatever your country is and then go to the official website. When you head there, you should be able to see the visa section, and from there go and apply to the right link of e-visa. Here you see there is an old link and a new link, but I'll go for the latest one, and I get on the page of e-visa application. Here there are some details, and the language is Vietnamese. I'll switch it to English. Not much details here, honestly. I don't see much. One important item is that the fee is $25 for a single entry visa and $50 for a multiple entry visa. Not much details to cover here, so let's head to the form. And here you can just move forward and click submit application and then go to the next step. Now this is the official page of applying for the e-visa. Here you can see what all details you need and what all you need to prepare, but let me tell you that you do need one photograph, you need your passport's front and back side image, and also you need to know the details of your entry and place of stay. When we proceed next, we are able to see the option to upload the photo. You will see that a lot of the fields here are not mandatory, so I will be skipping those as I don't want to put wrong information instead of no information. So I'll rather keep it empty, just adding some dummy details here for now and moving forward. So the email, you have to make sure that it carefully you're filling it out, because you will receive the confirmation on this email. Then filling out the further details, you have to make sure that you clearly mention single entry and multiple entry, which visa you're applying for, and also the dates. Try to keep within 30 days, and then you may enter contact information, but it's optional, so I'll keep it empty. Purpose of entry for me is tourism. I don't know why there are multiple options with this term tourism, but you can select the one that's relevant. And here I am sure that I'm entering with this to this checkpoint, so I have to make sure that I enter it correctly, and then just a tentative intended temporary stay as well. If you've been to Vietnam, you need to enter the details. I have not been, so I'll proceed forward. And then we also have to add the minors, if any, and also your trip's details, for example insurance, expenses, etc. Here I will add just some tentative expenses intended, so not much, and then also the health insurance that I've bought, entering the captcha, and that's it. Now this is a registration code. Now already you should have received an email after this step, and now we are able to proceed to the payments. You can review your application. It's already completed now, and we proceed to payment. And now you will have to make the payment online itself. There is no other way to make the payment. So you have you need to have your credit card or PayPal account or something to be able to make the payment. After filling out all the details for your payment for your credit card, you can also check the total amount and the conversion, etc. But here, simple payment. And once you complete the payment, you will receive an email. Now in that email, there will be a link for you to go and check your the status of your application. So make sure that you use this certain link, and I'll also post the link in the description box below. And finally, when you get the visa, this is the final email that comes up. So I hope this made it easy for you to prepare for the visa application for Vietnam. And if you have any questions, you can ask them in the comments. Thank you so much.